Hey guys, how's it going? So I wanted to do a quick box opening video for this new God of War game, and I wanted to do this video for a couple reasons. One, because I've been a huge fan of the series since the beginning of the series, and two, because there's a lot of hype surrounding this game, and I've been really hyped for this game to come out. I'm a big supporter of the franchise, so I picked this up earlier today, and I just got home from work, so now I'm really excited to open this up and see, really see for myself what you get. Of course, I have an idea from the back of this box, which you will see from everything that I will get, but to actually see it with my own eyes is going to be something completely different, and I'm really excited. And then lastly, I wanted to make this video just in case there's anyone out there who's wondering if this is going to be worth it. And I figured that could help you make a purchasing decision whether you want to get maybe the normal game, the special edition, or this is the Stonemason edition, the best edition that you could get for the game. And just to let you know, this edition will run you $150. With taxes and everything from where I live, it's ran me $160. With new games being around $60, that's almost double the price. So, it's going to be good to see if it's something that you want to buy. Just so you know, there is going to be a little bit of bias in this video, because it's going to be worth it no matter what for me, because again, I'm just such a huge fan of the series that I don't really mind if it's like not quite there in terms of worth. I'm just really happy to continue supporting the series and really excited to see where it's going to go. So, let's get started. So, of course, from you could see the front of the box here is Kratos and his son. So we're going to be able to see them now in terms of Nordic mythology instead of Greek mythology. So turning the box, you see some kind of rune, which I'm guessing is something from the Nordic mythology. Then the back here is everything you're going to get in this Stonemason edition, which I'm pretty excited to see. Another of the same rune from the opposite side of the box. And then this is the top of the box. So there was a sticker here holding the box closed. I already got rid of that so we could get right into it and see what we get. All right, so let's try to pull this out pretty carefully. I don't want to mess anything up. That's pretty well in there, but that's okay. There we go. Got it. Wow, okay. So I believe this is the entirety of the box right here. Yes, so this outer box right here is now empty. So I'm actually just going to close that back up. And I'll put that back there for now. So now you have this is what you saw coming out of the box. All right, so now you have Kratos and his son again. Turning it around, you get what looks to be a 180 dioramic image. And the back of the box seems to have another symbol or rune on it. That looks very interesting. All right, so now we get to the real meat of the matter. So opening it up, some more Nordic runes. Okay, so let's see. The very top here is the steelbook case for the game, and inside is the game as well as the digital content you get for getting the Stonemason Edition, which includes, let's see, the Death's Vow armor set, the Exile's Guardian Shield, Defender of the Chosen Shield, God of War Digital Comic Number 0 by Dark Horse Comics, God of War Digital Art Book by Dark Horse Comics, and a dynamic theme for the PlayStation 4. So I will download those later. And I also pre-ordered the game, so I have even more digital content. All right, so just to show you the completion here of the box as much as I can. So this top part is going to pop out. And it looks like there's something in the back of here, so I'm going to try to get this open from the side. Right there. I'm going to pull out a little tray. And there's a whole bunch of stuff back here. That looks very interesting. Okay. So this was the cardboard that the steelbook was sitting in, so that can go aside. Alright, so what we have here looks to be some kind of cloth or tapestry. Probably something of Nordic meaning. So I'm just opening it up. I'll show you guys as soon as it's all opened. Okay. Oh, it looks like a type of map. I'm going to try to get as much of it in as I can. Just so you could see all the corners. So this looks like something you could frame, potentially. Because this looks really cool. Let me check the back. Now the back is just cloth. Just in case something is double-sided, you never know. Okay, so I'm just going to fold this up nicely to make sure it stays. I'll put that right with the steelbook. So we got a couple boxes and bags here. So here's the first box with some runes on it. I'm going to pop this bad boy open and something in plastic here. We got a couple of figurines. What looks to be a six-legged horse and some sort of creature with horns. I think this might be a troll. We'll find out in the game, I guess. So, I'm just going to put these back temporarily. Alright, and here's the next box with runes on it. So let's open this bad boy. We have two more figurines in plastic. Trying to see if I could get you guys. There we go. A clearer picture. I'm not too sure who these guys are yet, but we will find out, I'm sure. So again, I'm just going to throw those back in plastic real fast. Excuse the noise. Alright, now we have a plastic bag with a bunch of runes on it. Looks like there's a little tear thing right here, so I'll tear that open. And we have what appears to be a keychain. Let me get some of this wrapping off of it. There we go. It is a keychain of a head. It's a little creepy. But okay. So I will pull the tab. And I'm not too sure what gets it to talk. But I think.
Call me Mimir, smartest man alive. And I have the answer to your every question.
Okay.
Call me Mimir,
okay.
Smartest man alive, and I have the answer to your every question.
So apparently this is a talking head keychain of Mimir. That's Mimir, a... Whoops. Well, we're just going to keep trucking. So, okay, I don't know what this is in plastic, but we will find out. So I don't want to bend this, so I'm going to try to open this very carefully. I'm going to throw all this trash aside real fast, excuse me. So this looks like a sticker, I believe. And this, whoa, oh, okay, it's a sort of envelope that's holding a picture of what is clearly Kratos and his son staring down what looks to be some sort of undead army, and there is a message on the back from Corey Barlog, the creative director. Okay, so I'm going to hold that still for just a second if you want to pause and read that. I'm going to slide that right back in here to keep it safe. And let's continue on. Okay, so I believe this big boy right here is going to be the statue. So this is what I'm really excited for. This is going to be a big selling point. Really careful with this. Right, so after this box right here, this box is now empty. The one with the rune on the back and Kratos and his son on the front. Oop. Sorry about that. So let's take a look here. Oh, okay. So firstly, we have another rune here and another rune there. And it seems like these two are cardboard pieces that just come off. So here's the statue, which I'm not getting a clear look of yet, but there's something inside of here. So let's see what that is. It's a little tight. So, this was attached to the inside, a box with a rune on it. And upon opening the box, we have a ring. Now, this looks very interesting. And this is really good to know. This is a really big ring. And I'm a big guy. I'm actually 6'4". And this can easily fit on my middle finger. So, that's really good to know. This ring is really cool. Let me hold it up closer real fast so you can get a good look at it. Just check this out. Has all different kinds of very odd markings on it. Again, I'm sure they have plenty to do with Nordic mythology. But very good to know that this is a big ring. That's very good to know. So I'm going to put that right back in the box for safekeeping. And now, onto the big meat of the matter. So this is all taped up, so I'm going to use my key to just carefully sort of cut around this tape. Oh man, this looks cool. I'm also trying to be a little quiet because it is late. Oh man. Well, there goes that idea. Oh, I see. It's also bubbled into each other. There we go. Okay. So now I'm going to be really careful here. Don't want any rough landings. Okay. Awesome. All right, so we're starting to get a clearer picture here. I'm going to put that aside. Undo the wrapping, and there we go. So I'm going to very carefully hold this up. Now this is a pretty hefty statue actually as well, and it's very, very detailed. You see, his son is point blank arrowing this, what appears again to be an undead soldier, through the eye, and it looks like Kratos is swinging through this man's neck, and I'm supposing this indicates momentum, so he is beheading whatever that is. And it is completely and utterly awesome. Plenty of detail. Underneath is, of course, copyright, Sony Interactive Entertainment. I think this is a serial number of some sort. So there you have it. So with the Stonemason Edition, you get the statue of Kratos and Atreus. A awesome ring. I'm really glad that that's actually wearable for me. What appears to be a sticker. A sort of picture, I believe it's called a lithograph, with a message that's on the reverse side. I'm going to keep it in this to keep it very safe. A couple of little figures and statues, which is really cool. A cloth map of what I'm supposing is the in-game world. A talking head keychain, which is a kind of weird little addition, but cool. And the steelbook case for the game itself, along with digital content. And what seems to be a pretty good amount of digital content. So I would say personally, even if you're not a hardcore God of War fan, this seems very, very worth it. You get a lot of cool little goodies in here. A lot of cool stuff that you can put on display to show, you know, that you are a fan. So I hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you like what you see, please support the series. And even if you aren't sure about the series and you just want to give the game a try, just the game alone, I wouldn't blame you, but I feel like you're not going to be disappointed. I've been hearing a lot of great things about this game, so with that, have a good one, and thanks for watching.